Hey guys, Daily Tech here, bringing you another gameplay video using Riftcat and the PS Move service. Now this time's a little bit different. We're not going to a Steam VR game, we're going to be playing a game that's meant for the Oculus Rift and the touch controllers. Now this is possible with a program called Revive. If you missed my video on how to get the game installed for free and play it with Revive, you can check the card in the top right of your screen. Also, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, this would be a good time to look down and click the subscribe button now. In this game, I'll be using the PS Navi controllers, and these things feel like they're built for Robo Recall. The three main controls you'll be using is going to be the touchpad, your grip, and your trigger. And the Navi controller, your touchpad is going to be just your joystick here, and when you teleport, you can pick which way you're going to face using the thumbstick. The grip to pick up weapons, that's right there. And then your trigger is right here, and that's going to be to shoot all your weapons as well. So moving around is great with the thumbstick, and then you've got your grab and your shoot right there, so it's perfect. I ran into one bug that gave me a little bit of grief. What happens is if you hold the direction on the thumbstick for too long, it ends up restarting the level. No idea why it does this. I don't know if this affects anyone else or if it's just me. But I do have a feeling it is just because I'm testing it out through the mod pack. So I'm curious to see if you guys run into the same issues too. Now I got a little bit of a warning or an apology for you because the mod pack running in the background is such a resource hog, I had to change my record settings down a little bit lower than I normally do. So unfortunately the gameplay footage isn't quite as crisp as I hope, but I promise you the graphics in this game are absolutely outstanding. Also, there is a mod for this game that's available to make it more compatible with a 360-degree setup. Unfortunately though, I'm not able to use it because you do need the full game to run that. What it does is it actually helps you teleport around. As it stands right now, out of the box, when you hold the thumbstick, you'll place an arrow on the ground. Whichever way that arrow is facing when you let go of it is going to be the front of your room. Now when you are looking backwards, it really throws you off and you end up spinning yourself around like a top trying to figure out which way you're standing. But that 360 mod just makes a small little adjustment and then makes that arrow the way that you're currently facing instead of the front of the room. That is going to make things way easier to play. But anyways, let's get ourselves into the gameplay. Here we go. Let's go and rip this robot to shreds. You, come here. Beat you down with your own head. The physics of this thing is awesome. There you go. You can throw your arm at your friends. Well, I can't rip your legs off. That'd be cool. Anyways. Let's go try out the first level. Alright. Now with that bug that I was talking about, it makes this a little bit difficult to get right in the right spot. There we go. Good password. It's password. Well done. Alright, let's get this first level.
Here, you can view your personal statistics. This is where you can track your performance.
I guess I'm still level one.
A few areas that need improvement, Agent 34. I'll have to make a note on your employee record.
City Center. I guess these ones are locked. I don't know if they're on. I don't think you're going to be able to play them with the demo here, but we'll see what happens. Start the mission.
Good luck out there, Agent 34. RoboReady's analytics team.
All right, here we go.
And defective robots. You'll be collecting them for us.
Reminds me of Street Fighter.
3, 2, 1, go!
Anymore?
Yes!
Oh.
Come here.
Come on, jump at me. Jump at me. I gotcha.
Bots in this area.
Get out of here.
Blasted good.
Oh yeah, gonna need guns for sure now. No! Oh, the bug got me.
RoboReady's analytics team wants to examine defective robots. You'll be collecting them for us.
3, 2, 1.
We'll come down. Beat you with your buddy's head. Where are they? No way. Bots. All right, let's see if we can do this.
3, 2, 1, go!
You should move soon.
Am I dead? Nope. All right. That's right, you run. Get out of here.
Move to the next location.
Where am I going? Oh. Oh man. Whew. I lost points. Oh, did I die? Jeez.
Don't stop now, Agent 34.
Melee mode active.
Where'd my guns go?
Agent 34, keep moving.
Oh, fuck. Shotgun. Whew.
Robo Ready's analytics team requests that you collect as many functioning products as possible.
Collect at least 10 bots. I'm gonna collect a bot.
3, 2, 1.
Uh-oh.
Go!
This is all new to me.
Put all items you collect into this vortex.
Shotgun! Where's that shotgun? Oh, do I have to grab you?
Power. Go get him, Tiger!
Throw him. There we go. I'm getting it. Return to the office. We done? Mission complete. Nice. Well, that game made me a sweaty mess, even after just that 15 minutes in the first level. And from what I hear, it gets even way better down the road with bigger and crazier guns. I, for one, am really happy to see that there's some quality VR games coming out. Oh, and you can apparently try different maps inside that level editor as well. Now, I'm a complete noob when it comes to using those mod kits, so I really haven't had much of a chance to mess around with it and figure things out yet. But I'm not quite sure if I'm going to spend the time to do it because I do plan on buying the full game anyways. But either way, thanks for watching this video, and don't forget to leave it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. We'll see you next time.